Welcome to the asana practice for improved concentration. Take as long as you like in each of the poses. Now the key is to stay present and aware of the movements, the sensations in your body and your breath. Before we begin, make sure you find a nice comfortable seat. Feel free to use as many props as you need. Blocks, cushions and blankets are really handy just to prop up the hips if you're hanging out for a while in a seated position, which we will be while we go through our Nadi Shodhana. Let us begin. Coming down to a kneeling position or cross-legged is fine. Otherwise, you could use a block and just prop that up underneath your hips as high as you like, and just make sure that you're in a position that allows you to have access to your spine, so the spine is long and comfortable and the head is free. So take your time, get comfortable, take a deep breath in and exhale. We're going to use our right hand and you're going to use your thumb to close your right nostril. Take a deep breath in through the left and then closing the left nostril with the little fingers, exhale through the right. Inhaling through the right. And then exhale through the left. Inhale through the left. And exhale through the right. Inhale through the right. And exhale through the left. Inhaling left. Exhaling right. Inhaling right and exhaling left. Inhaling left, exhaling right. Inhaling right, exhaling left. Go at your own breath pace. Beginning with the inhalation in the left and ending with the exhalation through the left. Just continue in through the left, out through the right, in through the right, and out through the left. Just finishing off your last breath, make fists with your hands, wrapping your fingers around your thumbs, and bring those fists in towards your thighs. You might want to come up into this position, the seated position, if you're not here yet. Connect to that breath, connect those hands in towards your hips and towards your thighs, and find your breath through the back of your body. Feel that breath expanding through the back of the body, up through the back of the shoulders, the neck, the lower body, the upper buttocks. And as you exhale, feel that space created in the abdomen. Inhaling into the back of the body and exhaling, feeling that space created. We're going to fold forward into a child's pose with those fists where they are. So just gently, as you're ready, take an exhalation, come down into your child's pose. Relax those shoulders. Relax the elbows. Let the elbows drop down and just feel the fists into your belly. As you breathe into your back, the body will slightly rise. And as you exhale, feel that excavation through the pelvic bowl. There's going to be more space for those fists there. Take a nice deep breath in through the back of the body. And as you exhale, you can feel that space, more space through the hips, through the belly, through the pelvis. Allow that lovely breath to fill your body. Take your time and just really concentrate on how that breath feels as you find it up through the back of the body. And then on your next inhalation, come up and make your way into a tabletop position, stacking your wrists underneath your shoulders and your knees underneath your hips. Just find some comfort here. And we we're going to move into Marjariasana cat pose. So feel your spine curling from the tailbone as you tilt the tailbone up, let the belly drop, press through the arms, open up the heart, gazing upwards. As we exhale, we're going to exhale with lion breath. So as you exhale, rounding the spine, belly comes in and stick your tongue out as far as you can, releasing that breath. As you inhale, roll your gaze up towards your eyebrow center, practicing Shambhavi Mudra. Just continue to move through your cat breath, inhaling, rounding the spine up, and exhale, release that breath out. Really sticking that tongue out. Moving into Sunbird, extending out through the right arm, left leg, and exhale, take it down. Inhale, extend up through the opposite limbs. Exhale, take those arms down. Inhale, rising up opposite limbs. Find that balance, find that focus, find that strength. Let's continue to follow your breath. Inhaling to extend out. Squaring the hips, lifting from the inner thigh of that raised leg. And as you exhale, just find that evenness through the body. Inhale, use the strength of the inner thigh. Try to drop the outer hip slightly so the hips remain square and you're not tilting it up. And then finishing it off, tucking your toes and sitting back onto your heels, just stretching out those feet. Your focus the whole time through this practice on your breath. Bring your hands to your heart center in Anjali Mudra. Take a moment, and when you feel that you found your balance, especially if you feel comfortable on your toes here, lift your knees off the ground, focusing at a drishti, a focal point in front of you. Find that balance. You can raise your arms overhead if you prefer, or you can just keep them down. You can also just keep those knees down if this is quite intense on your toes. There is a lot of intensity through here. And then bringing those hands back down to your chest, press up, come to standing, or just work your way up to a standing position in your own time. Come towards the front of the mat and find your mountain pose, your Tadasana. You want to find your equilibrium in this Tadasana. Breathe into the body from the head to the toes. See if you can find a lovely straight line from the ankles to the knees to the hips to those shoulders and up through the crown of the head. Lift the energy up through the back of the body, up through the spine and the back of the head. Soften the heart. Allow your hip points to slightly rise up and point towards your ribs, with the ribs softening down towards the hips. The tailbone is lengthened to the floor. There's a relaxed feeling in the tailbone. Stay facing the direction you're at. I'm just turning around so that you can see this pose. This is Lord Krishna's pose. He's playing the flute with a light smile on his face. So just finding your focus and finding your balance. And crossing your right leg over your left foot, lightly touching the floor with those toes, and then maybe just raising them off the ground slightly. And we're holding the flute. So the left hand comes in front of the body and the right hand faces away. You're making the rock on sign with your hands. The right hand is pointing out and the left hand is pointing towards you. Gaze gently towards the left with a light smile on your face. That is actually part of the pose. Bringing the hands down and we'll go to the other side. Left leg comes up over that right side, and again find that balance first. Bring the hands up and shift them across, turning your left hand out and your right hand towards your face, gazing to the right towards the ground, a lovely light smile. Just find that focus and breathe. taking your flute down and releasing out the step. Just gazing a few feet in front of you, coming into Tadasana again, this time with the hands in front of the heart center into prayer pose. And we're going to find our drishti, that focal point. Inhale, extend the arms overhead, interlace the fingers, press up to the toes and press those hands up to the sky. If the balance is a little off today, you can separate the feet slightly. Just keep on finding that focus, that balance. This is really good for building strength in the ankles. It elongates the spine. It releases the stress in the legs. As you exhale, bring the hands down. Maybe you can interlace the fingers the other way so the other pinky's on the outside. And as you breathe in, extend up to the sky. Continue to breathe as you hold that focus. Find that strength. And you can hold there for a few breaths. Come down and release the hands. Coming back into prayer pose. Now you can do that a few more times, or you can just hold the pose as much as you like. We're going to raise that right leg and do a little active balance pose, extending the leg out to the side and then extending it out forward, reaching that leg back behind you, coming into a warrior three balance. Now you don't have to go completely parallel like I am. You can stay more upright. You can also bring your hand to your standing leg to the top of the thigh there just to give you some support. And then we're going to sweep that leg forward again, bend the knee, bring it out to the side, bring it back into center, extend that leg out, lift it, use the strength of the inner thighs, release the feet to the ground. I'll just turn to the side so you can see it on the other side. Coming to the other side, lifting that leg, bending the knee, opening the hip out, bring it back to center, extend the leg forward, flex the foot, and reach that leg behind you. Coming into your warrior three, and again, you don't have to come completely parallel. You could come even further down, just testing your balance and your focus. Find that strength through that lengthened out leg, press through the standing leg. And then draw your left leg up, bending the knee, opening out to the side, bringing it back into center, extending the leg out in front of you, use the strength, and then release it down. And it doesn't matter if your leg doesn't go that high. It's just a really good way to build that balance and coordination into your body. Coming down to a seated position, stretching the legs out in front of you, just shift the flesh away from your hips. Extend up through the arms, interlacing the fingers, reaching up, and then reach out as you exhale, come forward slightly. Breathe into your back. As you exhale, feel more space created through the abdomen. Inhale, breathe into your back. Exhale, lengthen again, and just come to your furthest point. Once you've reached your furthest point, just rest there, breathing into the back and exhaling, feeling that space through the abdomen. You're going to feel a little rise up as you breathe into the back there, and you'll feel that release as you exhale into the abdomen, just slowly softening into this pose. You can reach beyond your feet if you've got more flexibility. You could even grab a block, bring it by your feet and extend beyond the block there, holding onto the block. Just to always work at your own level and always, always, always follow your breath. Inhale, draw the belly up and come up. And then shifting your hips towards the front of the mat slightly so that you can lie down, feeling nice and balanced. If you have a block nearby, you can bring that over close towards you. We're going to come into bridge. Feet are hip width apart, hands down by your side. Press through the feet, lift the hips. Spiral your inner thighs to the ground and your outer thighs to the sky. And then if you're stronger, you can lift your right leg up to the sky, extending it up 90 degrees or less. And you can also bring the hands underneath the body to support the body if you need to. Releasing that leg down, inhale up through the left side, or you can stay in bridge the whole time. Make sure the head and the neck are comfortable. There's a little space for the chin and the chest. And exhale, bring those legs down. Grabbing your block. Now you can place it at any level. If you don't have a block, a big fat book or a rolled up towel will do. And we're just gonna raise the hips and come into a lovely, easy shoulder stand inverted posture. So setting your hips down onto your prop and lifting those legs up, and you can stay there. Arms can be wherever you like. If you are familiar with a shoulder stand, you can choose to do that instead. Using the block, if you're a lady and you have your period, that's a nice easy way to do it without doing shoulder stands. And I've just shown you a variation of holding onto your hips and just letting your knees fall towards your ears. That's another option. Otherwise, you can do a half shoulder stand, extending the legs up, and you're more in a V position, which you saw earlier, or a full shoulder stand, taking those feet up towards the sky, making sure that you're supporting your back, gazing at your toes, energy up to the sky. You can get as vertical as you like here, but really it's not about pushing the asana today. It's really about bringing that focus into the body, feeling the sensations in the body. If you're comfortable with trying some variations, you can bend that knee, the right leg, slide it down to the left knee, and place your right knee on your forehead, right at that Agna Chakra, that space of intuition at the center of your forehead. You can swap sides and just breathe into it, finding that support, finding that balance. These are just options. You don't need to do these. You can just stay with your legs on that block and just breathe into it, enjoying that inversion. As an alternative, you could also just take your legs up the wall. That's a lovely supported inversion as well. Gently bring the legs back down, rolling those legs down, working that core for a moment. And as a nice counterpose to our shoulder stands and our bridges, we're going to come into fish. So bring your hands underneath your hips, palms facing down. You're literally sitting on your arms. Press through those forearms, press up through the elbows, open the chest up to the sky, and then gently drop the crown of the head towards the ground. Keep opening the chest to the sky. Breathe into it, and then lifting the head, slowly release down. And just as another little counter pose for the fish pose, interlace your fingers behind your head, elbows point to the sky, just gaze towards your feet for a moment as you lift the head, release it down, give yourself a hug, wrap those arms around you, hug your knees in, rock around a little bit, and then dropping the knees to the right, gazing over to the left. You can experiment with where your arms go as well. Don't be afraid to experiment with your asana and find out what's comfortable. For those of you that want to go into a deeper stretch from that twist, just scoot your lower leg behind you, the one that's on the ground. Shoot it back, find a comfortable place for your hips. We're coming into cattail pose, just creating a little back bend and a little twist in the body. And then you can release the arm, release the legs back out, or stay in cattail just for a moment. Draw those knees up, hug them in, and then drop them to the other side. And again, you can choose to go into cat pose by sending that lower leg back behind you. Shift your hips until you can get into a comfortable twisted position, reaching back for your back ankle. You don't need to do this, but it is a lovely twist for the spine, and it's also a lovely gentle back bend as well. And then gently release out from your cat. You can stay in the twist for a few more breaths. Bring the knees back up. Just center those hips. Make sure you're nice and comfortable. Rock around. And release down into Shavasana, your final resting pose. Allow the whole body to melt into the floor. Soften all of the limbs. Soften the breath. No more effort is required from your breath. Just listen to the gentle rise and fall of the belly. And you can stay here as long as you like.
allowing each part of the body to relax deeper and deeper. Namaste. Thank you for joining me today.